1941 West Crest Drive, Houston, Texas. Every summer for 21 years, Houston, Texas. Long road trips across treeless plains, endless hours playing counting games. From everywhere I've lived, the miles and miles I'd go. Houston, Houston is in my soul. Houston, Houston, I call home. Backyard swing in the old live oak. Granddad on the porch with a tall lone star. Pocket full of dimes from grandma's purse. Hard candy treats from the corner store. Teeth all stuck with a mouth full of jujubes. Hanging with my brother watching Tarzan movies. From everywhere I've lived, miles and miles I'd go. Houston, Houston is in my soul. Houston, Houston, I call home. I found my first lucky penny on the sidewalk on Long Point. I spent my first night with my love in her flat on Montrose. All my best friends were from Bel Air. My best summer job was at the Herman Park Zoo. If I had to do it again, I might have never left Texas. I'd be living in Houston. Nothing against my life today. I love my wife and my family. It's just a thread that calls me to walk with the ghosts of towns and guy. And here, old Steve, Houston, Houston is in my soul. Houston, Houston, I call home. Houston, Houston is in my soul. Houston, Houston, I call home. Houston, Houston is in my soul. Houston, Houston, I call home. I spent my life leaving you to come back. When I was there, my roots grew deep. I found myself and I moved on. 1841 West Crest Drive, Houston, Texas. Thank you.
Bob Howard on River City Folk. I'm your host, Tom May. You are listening to this weekly broadcast of live performance, musical influence, and interview here at Cafe Artichoke in Portland, Oregon. And this is the first live show that we have done in the wake of the pandemic since things began to be relaxed enough that we could have live people here in this fabulous listening venue. And Bob, you started out your life in Texas, obviously, and then eventually moved to my hometown in Nebraska, Omaha, where this show is heard and where you spent some of your working life, and then came out to Portland, Oregon, and eventually got hooked up with Artichoke and decided when it was in danger of vanishing, you decided to take it on and direct your energy and resources into making it the place it is, with a lot of help from people like Don Wheatley, who's here this afternoon, in making it happen. But it was really yourself and your commitment that made this somehow survive. What was the thought process that you said to yourself, I can make this happen, I can make this work?
Well, that's the problem. My wife tells me often, there's no thought process. It's just both feet in, and how can I help, is how some of this often starts. But it was at a critical time in 2016 when the building and Hawthorne, after so many years that Kate and Steve had acquired there and moved the store to the 31st and Hawthorne location, had been sold. And I think the board in place was desperate at that time to figure out, well, whether or not we could negotiate a lease that would work at the location where it existed, or whether or not we would have to find a place. And they asked me if I could help. And since that had been most of my career of working in business, I stepped in and took the role of treasurer and tried to figure out how we could do this.
And thank goodness you did. There's only a few spots in the United States like Artichoke Music, the Old Town School of Folk Music in Chicago, Swallow Hill Music in Denver, but very, very few places like Artichoke. And we're so, so very grateful that you did that, Bob, and somehow kept the whole operation functioning through this last year with all of its challenges. Bob, you brought in some recordings for us to hear today that have meant a lot to you. This first one is by Fred Neil, a song that people will know called Everybody's Talking. Of course, what a lot of people don't know about Fred Neil is for a long time he went ahead and coordinated the open mic in New York City, in Greenwich Village, at the Gaslight. So he was very acquainted with rooms like what we are experiencing this afternoon at Artichoke. What is it about Fred's music that always attracted you to him?
Well, you know, I've always come to much of the originators of some of my favorite songs through others. So the first time I heard Everybody's Talking was when Nielsen did it, and which led me to a bit of the history. But I just love it, you know, the idea of setting sail.
Everybody's talking at me, don't hear a word they're saying, only the echoes of my mind.
An eerie silence on the other end. My mind fills the space, my thoughts descend. A faint hello tells me you're there. No clues to tell me where you are. When stay
on the line. Stay. On the line, stay beside me, stay on the line. It's 2 a.m. and the phone rings twice. I pick up the line, it's as cold as ice. I hope to God that you call back. The night is long, the blackness attacks. When will you come back? Stay. Months, months become years. Stark images fill like stars across a black sky. Sunrise brings hopes you may reappear. Sunset leaves me facing my deep fears. Have you found where stay on the line? Stay.
Howard on River City Folk with a song called Stay on the Line. Bob was preceded by a recording by Fred Neil of Everybody's Talkin', the great song that was used back in the 1980s or 70s, I can't remember, in the movie Midnight Cowboy, correct?
So that's right.
It was a really big song at the time. I'm sure you're familiar with it. Wonderful tune. So, Bob, one of the things you try to do here at Artichoke Music is you try to get people that perhaps were not playing, have not been playing music, to incorporate it into their lives, to enrich their lives through the power of song. You call it live life in song, and that's really been a big part of the mission at Artichoke here.
Right. It has. It's always been a place, and I've used this several in writing grants, it's a place where somebody can come buy an instrument, take a lesson, go to their first open mic, and actually begin a career. There are so many people that have been on the Artichoke open mic stages throughout the year that have gone on to be commercial artists, and that all started with a love of maybe picking up an instrument and making that a part of their life.
And one of the things that happens here at Artichoke, in addition to the little hall that we're in right now, is right next door, there are extensive opportunities for people to take classes from great instructors. So that's right. That's a part of what happens here at Artichoke Music. But regardless of what they do with what they've learned, their life is immeasurably enriched by the experience of music. And I think that's why you became so enamored of the whole idea of carrying this on.
I just couldn't see it stop, Tom. I mean, at that particular point, it's a matter of trying to see, with all the volunteers that have been a part of this, what we could do and if we can organize ourselves to find a new place and carry on.
Bob, you've got another song for us to hear. This song made popular by Joan Baez, she wrote it, and it was truly well-known in the 1970s. I played this song for years and years. Used to love doing this tune, actually, believe it or not. Diamonds and Rust, it had that great guitar lick in it that I always got a big kick out of. And what exactly was it with this song, Bob, that made you choose this as an influence of yours today?
I'll be damned. The line opens it. And so it kind of goes into the next song that I'll play. It's just these kinds of snippets of words that come to your mind. But I just love a song that started, I'll be damned. And how many times have we said that? And then you listen to the story, of course, and you know, you can imagine Joan reflecting on her life with Bob, and you know, it just goes on to tell that story. But it that moment that it just starts with, I'll be damned.
Well, I'll be damned. Here comes your ghost again. But that's not unusual. It's just that the moon is full and you happen to call.
Since I left Omaha, as far as I knew, I was going to Vietnam. My lucky number was 57. Moon found heaven closer to home. Found my heaven on the road. I followed the sunsets to oceans blue. The moon stayed at home. Golden fields and white skies, each heaven. Calls from Texas. She lives in Pflugerville. She was my queen of the tasty freeze. After school, my heaven was framed in neon blue. After all these years, she's only 18 miles from South Congress Avenue. The jukebox is gone, and her curly blonde hair, when she danced along, a touch of blue filled the air. draft was canceled. Dick Nixon made my day. I never went to Vietnam. Everything I owned I packed in the back seat of my red Beetle ragtop. Interstate 35 to San Marcos. And after 3 years, the California closed. Out on the road, out on the edge, I took my chances. Heaven leaned close. I found my heaven on the road. I followed the sunsets to ocean's blue. The moon stayed at home. Golden fields and white skies, each heaven to their own.
Pieces of music in that set, beginning with Joan Baez, her classic song Diamonds and Rust. She was followed by my guest today on the program, Bob Howard, with his song Out of the Blue. You are listening to River City Folk, a weekly broadcast of live performance, musical influences, and interview this week live at Artichoke Music in Portland, Oregon. Yeah! And I'd like to say hello to all the people who listen to River City Folk each week on radio station WETS in Johnson City, Tennessee. Thanks very much for tuning into the program today. Bob, I know that songwriting for you has been a journey in these recent years that has been helped along a lot by our friend Matt Meehan, and some of the work that you did with him and his songwriting classes has meant a lot to you as a songwriter.
Absolutely. You know, when I retired from my career, my wife had suggested that I start taking up guitar. And I did that, and I was teaching kids. But I went to the Sisters Folk Festival for my first time since I'd been in California. And I just had such a great experience, and that's where I met Matt. And the rest is history. I mean, his cues, his part, his long association and dedication to Artichoke has been legendary, and it's been great.
Matt is one of our esteemed teachers here, not only of songwriting, but also of guitar. And Matt is a really, really very treasured member of the acoustic music community here in Portland, Oregon, Matt Meehan. You've got a song for us to hear here, Bob, I'm a Believer by Neil Diamond. Of course, most people first heard this when the Monkees had a monster hit with it back in the 1960s. Neil Diamond was very, very thankful, I'm sure, because he had a monster royalty check, I'm positive, after that was such a big hit on the radio. So of the songs that you chose today as an influence on you, what made you decide to include this one?
Well, I just love the song. I mean, reading high fashion magazines explains it all in terms of what may be going wrong with your girlfriend or some understanding of what people know. I loved rock and roll. My first album was Out of Our Heads by the Rolling Stones. That I bought that when I was 10 years old. And I pretty much exclusively listened to rock and roll until Neil Young came out with his first solo album. And then I discovered a little bit more about singer-songwriter, but turns he was pretty much of a rock star too, so...
Indeed.
So, there we go.
Anyway, we're going to go back and visit this great old pop tune from the 60s, but written by Neil Diamond, and it's called I'm a Believer.
I thought love was only true in fairy tale, meant for someone else but not for me. Love was out.
One black shoe, one black shoe, one black shoe, one black shoe, one black shoe left behind, one black shoe, no other clue. Early one morning, 2 hours past midnight, same old crowd, the room was loud. There she stood, misunderstood. She's looking for someone, she's welcoming no one. It's one black shoe, one black shoe, one black shoe left behind, one black shoe, no other clue. Open the door, same as before. Nothing stops me, I'm feeling no pain. Needing some coffee, I'm needing to see. I'm searching in time for some clue. One black shoe, one black shoe, one black shoe left behind, one black shoe, no other clue. Maybe not. Just one black shoe, no other clue. Sometimes there are no answers. Just one black shoe,
to misconstrue. One black shoe. One black shoe. One black shoe left behind. One black shoe. No other clue.
In the set of music you just heard, we had Neil Diamond with I'm a Believer, and then my guest today, Bob Howard, the executive director of Artichoke Music here in Portland, Oregon, with a song called One Black Shoe. Again, we're celebrating today because this is the first time in quite some time we've had a live audience here at Artichoke Music, a unique business in Portland, Oregon that emphasizes the worth of everyone that picks up an instrument that tries to express themselves. There's no wrong answers here. Everyone is encouraged to learn and to share, and that's what Artichoke Music and other installations, whatever few of them there are in this country, are all about. So, Bob, I know how difficult it must have been and how nerve-wracking it must have been to put this all together and to keep it going since then. What is your fondest memory that you can recall since you opened the door here on Powell Boulevard?
Honestly, Tom, my fondest memory is the day that at one of our open mics on Thursday night, that a person was here in a wheelchair and they came up on stage via the ADA accessible ramp and played a song, and they came up on stage under their own power. It was just a great sight. Matt Meehan was hosting that night, helps them get settled on stage, but it was just a beautiful moment.
That sounds incredible, and I'm sure that's a memory that that person still cherishes when they think about that evening.
I hope so. I hope so.
I'm certain they do.
Yeah.
But it has meant so much to so many people to have Artichoke here for them to be able to exercise their creative impulse and talent. A really marvelous thing that's very unusual in this world that we live in. Bob, you've got one more recording for us to hear today, and this is by Neil Young, and a song that I remember well, again, from back in the 70s, I think this particular song was from, Cowgirl in the Sand, another Canadian. What is it about this particular song of Neil's that made you choose this one?
It was just the striking contrast of Hello, Cowgirl in the Sand. Just what are you doing there? And how that image, you know, appears in there. I just loved every Neil Young song I heard for through his first three albums.
The first time I heard the song, I was in Canada, and I was performing myself in a little town on the north shore of Lake Ontario, and I'd never heard the song. This kid was sitting down and playing the song, and I thought to myself, well, pretty good song. Did you write that? No, he didn't write that, but it was an interesting song, and I'm glad you chose it. I haven't heard it in a long time. Neil Young with Cowgirl in the Sand.
Hello, cowgirl in the sand. Is this place at your command? Can I stay here for a while?
You are listening to River City Folk. We just heard Neil Young with Cowgirl in the Sand. I'm going to join my guest today, Bob Howard, on this song, One Day. And Bob, where'd you find this tune? It's a fun song.
It came from the kids that I teach in North Portland at the Portland Tennis and Education Program, which is an after-school enrichment program for at-risk youth. And we always had sing-alongs, and I would try to do songs that they wanted to hear. And they brought me this song, and I was just completely struck by it.
We're going to ask the audience here at Artichoke to join us on this song, too. And while they're doing that, wherever you happen to be listening, we hope you do the same.
Sometimes I lay under the moon, I thank God I'm breathing. Then I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more wars, and our children will play one day.
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 One day. It's not about win or lose, 'cause we all lose. They feed on the souls of the innocent, blood-drenched pavement. Keep on moving, though the waters stay raging. In this maze, you can lose your way, your way. It might drive you crazy, but don't let it faze you. No way, no way. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more wars, and our children will play one day.
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 One day,
one day, one day this all will change and treat people the same. Stop with the violence, down with the hate. One day we'll all be free and proud to be under the same roof, singing songs of freedom like way-oh, 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 way-oh. I've been praying for the people to say that we don't want to fight no more. There'll be no more wars, and our children will say one day.
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 Boy, I could hear you all singing all over the United States on that song called One Day. My guest is Bob Howard. Right before that, we heard a recording by Neil Young, Cowgirl in the Sand. I'm your host, Tom May. You are listening to Music That Makes a Difference on River City Folk. Bob, you have been toiling away in the folk salt mines here this last few years. And it indeed has made a difference in the community. I'm absolutely convinced of that. Another one of your precepts is to be inspired by everything. And I think that comes through the minute anybody walks in the door here at Artichoke Music, the kindness and the interest and the sense that you are worthwhile once you walk in this door. Whether you're a musician or not, or just thinking about playing music, or you're a songwriter or a professional touring artist, you make everybody welcome. But that's always been what you have set out to do here, if I'm correct.
I think so. I mean, it is a community. And I think in community, without the support of others, hard times are hard to get through.
And we're so very, very pleased that through your efforts and the efforts of folks who believe in this kind of institution, that you have kept the doors open this past year through the pandemic, through these incredibly difficult times. And as we move forward, there are going to be so, so many people who appreciate what's been done here. Bob, you're going to give us one more song to take us out of the program today, a song that reflects your attitude and all of our attitudes as we look down towards the light at the end of the tunnel. This is a song called Bright Side.
And I'm hoping for that.
as are we all. When did you write this song, Bob?
I wrote this song in probably 2011. It was one of the first songs I wrote as a songwriter. And it was funny. I had help from people like Dan Dover. And of course, it was inspired by some prompts that Matt gave me in a songwriting class after I took that. But it was in 2011.
Bob Howard on River City Folk to take us out today with a song called Bright Side.
Everywhere I go, everything I do, I look at the bright side. All along the way, every single day, I look at the bright side. When it all gets dark and there's no place to park, I look at the bright side. Look at the bright side. Reach for the stars, reach for the stars. I set a course, I found a path. Look at the bright side, my glass is half full, it's never empty. Look at the bright side. I eat my Wheaties for breakfast. Let the sun shine in. Look at the bright side. Reach for the stars. Reach for the stars. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Never surrender who you are. Reach for the stars. Reach for the star. I am true to myself, I wear a smile on my face, I loosen up my jaw, I slow down my pace, I eat my Wheaties for breakfast, let the sun shine in, keep an open mind, I practice patience, I share stories, I open my inner self, I find a way to be myself, and I do unto others as I do myself, and I love. Yes, I am gonna find a way to share. Every day there's a new door to open. Lessons learned are found everywhere. Reach for the stars, reach for the stars. Reach for the stars, reach for the stars. Reach for the stars, reach for the stars.
I look at the bright side. 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 I look at the bright side.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, Tom. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.